The main purpose of the Bloor West Village 3-day Ukrainian festival is to present the wide-ranging flavor of Ukrainian heritage to mainstream Canada. The festival's main attraction is the non-stop 3-day entertainment program on the huge professional festival stage set in the middle of Bloor Street, one of Toronto's main thoroughfares. Within the first moments of the festival opening on Friday evening, the Desna Dance Ensemble welcomed the festival-going public with a lively traditional Ukrainian welcome dance. Just before the official opening, the festival completed a live TV transmission with Ukraine's most popular TV talk show, Schuster Live. The show's host, Petro Maha, was on the Bloor West Village Festival stage and hosted this first-time link with Ukraine.
Петр Мага, що ти робиш в сторон?
Доброї ночі, Савік. Я останні 40 хвилин з натовпом людей дивимося програму на найбільш українській вулиці, яка називається Bloor. Знаходиться вона в Торонто. Тут сьогодні стартує великий український фестиваль. Як сказав мені його засновник Юрій Клюфас, завтра тут очікують прем'єр-міністра провінції Онтаріо, мера Торонто. Тут настільки поважають українців. Сьогодні тут буде велике єднання. У минулому році тут зібралося більше ніж 600 тисяч людей. Сьогодні тут будуть виступати Василь Попадюк, буде виступати гурт «Козак Сістем», буде виступати Тарас Чубай, велика виставка фотохудожника з Франції українського, якого звати Юрій Білак. І повірте, тут настільки велике єднання українства на цій вулиці, що я дуже хотів би, щоб в Україні коли-небудь люди так само збиралися. Завтра я подарую цю картину з Тарасом Григоровичем Шевченко від всієї України прем'єр-міністру Онтаріо. І навіть якщо вони будуть...
Well, Bloor's beginning. And it's 5 o'clock and it's sound check time. Kozak System's on stage getting ready to do their sound check, as well as Vasil Popadyuk's band is sort of assembling because they're performing tonight with Taras Chubai, and tomorrow Kozak System is performing. So it's a little hectic right now. People are running around trying to get things ready to go, and I'm probably in their way, but I don't really care. So it's Bloor. Yesterday it was hot and humid, today it's cold, which might be a little bit better. They were saying that their instruments don't stay in tune as well, the acoustic instruments, but like Vasil Popadyuk said, that's okay. So we look forward to seeing you here at the festival this year. Mind you, by the time this gets aired, you will already have been at the festival this year. But we're ready to have some fun and stay Ukrainian, my friends. We'll talk to you later.
This evening, as part of the festival's program, the Canadian Ukrainian Art Foundation hosted the opening of its unique exhibit, Toronto the Beautiful, a competition open to all artists.
On behalf of KONTAKT Gallery, it is my pleasure to welcome you to this unique exhibition, Toronto the Beautiful. It was thought for the artists to showcase their talent and to celebrate the beauty of Toronto. Beauty of Toronto is expressed through the eyes of artists. As you can see, artists are very unique, and they see beauty quite differently than us, just ordinary people who just appreciate art. We extend our congratulations to all the artists who participated in this contest.
The purpose of the festival is to present Ukrainian culture to mainstream Canada, and we are extremely proud that KONTAKT is part of our presentation and helps push our agenda forward.
The first place, $500, sponsored by the Ukrainian Credit Union, is José Duranlo with Sunday Stroll at Sunnyside Beach and CNT, Round and Round We Go. Please come forward, thank you.
Toronto artist José Duranlo was the first place winner.
I'm still in shock, to be quite honest with you, because I was looking at all the artists and I thought, oh, there's so much great art, and I never expected that I would come in first place, so I think I'm still in shock and a lot of emotions.
The People's Choice Award went to Andriy Babich of Toronto. At this same moment, on the west end of the festival, world-renowned violin virtuoso Vasil Popadyuk entertained festival visitors with a unique concert program. Famed poet and rock star Taras Chubayev, K of Ukraine, was the special guest star of this Friday night concert.
Я піду в далекі гори на широкі полонини і попрошу вітру зворю, аби він не спав днини, щоб летів на вільних крилах на кичери і діброві дізнався, де моя мила карі.
After the festival stage program, the festival organizers invited one and all to a festival after party to meet the members of the next day's headline act, Kozak System from Ukraine, sponsored by the Ukrainian Credit Union. Traditionally, Saturday, the second day of the festival, starts off with a community parade that marshals at 10 a.m. in Toronto's famous High Park. On this morning, 70 different organizations with 2,000 participants made this year's parade the biggest and most colorful ever. The award for the best non-commercial entry went to the Toronto Police, and the best commercial entry was won by the Ukrainian Credit Union with a float built by Kosa Collective.
We just found out a few minutes ago that we won the prize for the best float, and that's the second year in a row.
Is that because you were the only float? Or
No, there was many, many floats, but ours, we've collaborated with Kosa Collective twice now, 2 years in a row, and both times they've come up with a very spectacular float.
This is the Kosa Collective exhibit. This is a hutzul from the Carpathian Mountains in the forest, as you can see. And Marichka, why don't you tell them what we're doing here?
So we've got a hutzul man here and his helping ladies, his alligator wife, and his pretty little, I don't know, mistress, friend, his daughter, his hutzul daughter. And he's walking, he's taken his traditional Ukrainian beautiful wood homeland with him.
By the end of the parade, there are over 1,000 festival goers who have flocked to the main festival stage in anticipation of the official festival opening ceremony. Greetings from the government of Ukraine, represented by the ambassador of Ukraine to Canada, Vadim Pristaiko.
Україна вже доросла дівчина, 22 роки, вона готова піти далі в світ. Вона хазяйновита, вона гарна, ми любимо її всі. Вона ще має багато що зробити, але нам потрібна, Україні потрібна наша допомога. Потрібні щирі друзі такі, як Канада. Потрібні всі ми з вами. Тож давайте будемо працювати разом, відпочивати разом. Слава Україні!
Greetings from the Government of Canada in Ottawa were read by the new Minister of Canadian Citizenship, the Honorable Chris Alexander.
Вітаємо і дякую. Thank you so much for inviting us here. This festival means so much to our government. It means so much to our city and our province and our country. And I'm proud to be here with my colleagues from the Senate of Canada, from the House of Commons.
The minister presented Festival Chair Jurij Klufas the Queen's Diamond Jubilee Award for founding and developing this festival, as well as for the creation of KONTAKT Ukrainian TV Network.
Bloor Street has meant a lot to me growing up, going to school a little bit east of here, being in the Canadian Foreign Service, watching Canada be the first country in the world to recognize Ukraine's independence, working hard to make sure we were true to that commitment to our relations with Ukraine, and this festival has been at the heart of that process for decades now. And so I'd like to call Jurij forward, if he's still here, if he hasn't disappeared. Jurij, to receive something he's probably not expecting, because the time for these medals is for the most part past, but there are a certain number of them left. And this, Jurij, is a token of our esteem for you and of Canada's sincere thanks for your years of service to this festival. It's a Diamond Jubilee medal, but it's also, in this case, do gramadu. Can you put it on him? Jurij has done so much within his business, KONTAKT Entertainment, and for 17 years as head of this festival. It was time that we honored that with this presentation today. And we wish him Mnohaya Lita.
Mnohaya Lita, Lita. Mnohaya Lita, Lita.
Greetings from Prime Minister Stephen Harper were read by the Chair of the Canada-Ukraine Parliamentary Friendship Committee.
I would like to thank the organizing committee and all of the community sponsors for their hard work in preparing this popular celebration. This event will certainly be a worthy reflection of the pride felt by Ukrainian Canadians in their rich heritage. Please accept my best wishes for a most enjoyable festival. The Right Honorable Stephen Harper, Prime Minister of Canada.
Greetings from the province of Ontario were presented by none other than the Premier of the province, Kathleen Wynne.
Dobry den, everyone. It's wonderful to be here. Thank you so very much for inviting me. Thank you to all of the volunteers who have worked so hard with Jurij and with the team to make this such a successful, successful festival. And we're so proud to support North America's largest Ukrainian street festival, and I am so pleased to be here with you. I want to just say that earlier this month we marked Ukrainian Heritage Day to acknowledge and to celebrate the vital contributions that you make to the province of Ontario. And you are a vital, vital community. You only have to look out here today.
On occasion of the 200-year anniversary of the birth of Ukrainian poet Taras Shevchenko, Peter Maha of the Schuster live TV show in Kyiv, Ukraine, on behalf of the All-Ukrainian Coalition, presented the premier with an engraving of Taras Shevchenko authored by Parisian artist Yervan Bouvet.
I хочу сказати, що наша планета стала настільки маленькою і глобальною, що до 200-ліття великого Тараса Григоровича Шевченка фотоколаж зробив французький фотохудожник Ервен Буве. Привіз я його сюди, до Канади, польськими авіалініями, А двічі нерви мені псували митники однаково, як в Україні, так і в Канаді. Але я дуже радий, що вона нарешті тут, і я можу вам її вручити. Будь ласка, привітайте і з днем народження Шевченка, який буде в наступному році, я маю можливість привітати всіх, і слава Україні. Пам'ятайте, звідки ви, друзі. Ми вас любимо. Спасибі велике.
The festival area's federal representative MP Peggy Nash is present at the festival every year.
Thank you for your determination to form an independent country in Ukraine, your determination to fight for human rights, democracy, the rule of law, and thank you for never letting the world forget the terrible tragedy of the Holodomor, the famine, genocide. Thank you for your leadership in that. And I want to recognize the Premier, Kathleen Wynne, Sherry DeNovo. Thank you for finally getting this Holodomor studies in the provincial curriculum. So important for our young people. So thank you for achieving that.
We have a good example here of people working together for a common cause. And I want to tell you that the Holodomor bill was the very first bill, I think in Canada, certainly in Ontario, that all three political parties co-authored. That in itself is an act of peacemaking. So you Ukrainian Canadians made that happen. Give yourselves another round of applause.
The local city councillor, Sarah Doucette, is responsible for this area on the municipal level and is also with us every year.
Welcome to Bloor West Village and to Ward 13. So who here is the first time visiting this festival? Who's a newbie here? Wow, fantastic, well, welcome. And I do want to confirm what my MP and my MPP have said. This is the most amazing part of a city. Personally, I think this is the best part of a city, but that's me. So please, enjoy the festival. You've got amazing stalls down here. Go see the vendors. And remember our stores on the side as well.
To help with the ribbon-cutting ceremony, past parade marshals were summoned to the front of the stage. Ron Lennick, Victor Malarik, Jim Temertay, and Eugene Melnick, who received a recognition award for his multi-year sponsorship of the festival.
I am very, very proud of being a Canadian. But I'm also deeply proud of my Ukrainian heritage. Thank you. In fact, I was just in Ukraine this summer at a camp which I try to help out as a special charity of orphans. It's called Help Us Help the Children. And I was able to see firsthand some of the great work that Canadians do overseas for their fellow Ukrainians that are less fortunate than them. And I'm very proud of them. And like many Ukrainians here today, we are very proud of Canada. We're glad to be here. We're happy to be here. We're thankful to be here. And we continue our proud heritage. And before I hand the mic over, I want to thank the residents and the businesses of Bloor West. Your support for this festival and for the Ukrainian community means a lot to me and my family. Duzhe dyakuyu, thank you, and I hope all of you enjoy this weekend's festivities. Slava Ukraini.
At this point, the festival chair presented this year's parade marshal, world-renowned journalist and author Kristiu Freeland.
She most recently worked as managing director and editor of the Consumer News at Thomson Reuters. After cutting her journalistic teeth as a Ukrainian-based stringer for the Financial Times, Washington Post, The Economist, Freeland went on to wear many hats at the Financial Times, including deputy editor, UK news editor, Moscow bureau chief, European Europe correspondent, now you see why I had to read this, editor of its weekly edition and editor of FT.com. She has authored two very successful books, and she was the winner of the Lionel Gelber Prize for Journalism this year. So let's welcome the parade marshal for 2013, Kristiu Freeland, and her daughter, Halina. And now, ladies and gentlemen, and Halina, prosimo duje, everybody please help Halina. Hey, дякую. And ladies and gentlemen, let the party begin.
This time it was the Szizokryli Dance Ensemble from New York, USA, to present the symbolic welcome dance for officials of all three levels of Canadian government with performers and visitors from all across Canada, USA, and Europe. Dance ensembles from the USA and Western Canada were brought here thanks to funding by Celebrate Ontario, GTA performers and heritage activities supported by a grant from Heritage Canada.
Over the three-day period of non-stop entertainment on the festival main stage, there were about 800 performers, representing many Ukrainian artistic ensembles from Canada, USA, and Ukraine. At the other end of the festival, visitors had a very interesting opportunity to visit a unique exhibit authored by photographer Jurij Klufas from Paris, focused on the Hutsul mountain people and region of Western Ukraine.
Французи були вражені бачити, що десь 3 години літаком ще то Європі, що існує такий народ, такий колоритний, для них то було величезна екзотика. І знаєте, у Франції, напевно, як дуже багато країн, то ми чуємо про Україну тільки по, ну, вони побилися, вони билися на Верховній Раді, говоримо про фемін, мафію, Чорнобиль, але дуже рідко по таких дуже позитивних тематики. То вони були вражені бачити, що ця країна має такі скарби, і особливо ну, гуцулі мають таку глибоку культуру, що показати їх то просто дійсно екзотика.
On the second festival stage, visitors were presented with a fashion show of colorful textiles designed by Maria Barmina of Kyiv.
The collection is aptly named Love Ukraine, something which Maria encourages each and every one of us to continue doing. Festivals such as this one are tangible evidence of how much vitality Ukrainian culture has. Enjoy the fashion show.
Saturday, the longest of the three festival days, about 300,000 visitors enjoyed a beautiful day at the festival. This year, there were 52 artisan kiosks, 7 cultural pavilions, and 14 food stations.
Далі нам погодилася дати інтерв'ю пані Лідія Смілка, директор культурних програм Інституту Святого Володимира. Отже, пані Лідо, розкажіть нам, от ви поставили палатку на Блурі. От розкажіть нам про речі, які ви тут представляєте.
Знаєте, фактично всі ці організації, що тут представлені, це не тільки інститут, це ті, що підтримують інститут, це ті, що ми об'єднуємо під собою разом, ніби під шатром інституту, як об'єднується українська громада.
I'm from Vancouver. This is my very first time out in Toronto at the Ukrainian Festival here. Very exciting to be able to display and to serve the community of Toronto and the Ukrainian dance and Ukrainians here with my artwork. I've got a 20-year history in Vancouver with the Ukrainian dance community, performing myself with Tropak Ukrainian Dance Theater and teaching a number of dance groups through the years, choreography, etc., etc.
Ви зараз стоїте на Блурі і от поставили речі з музею і бачите, як люди проходять повз і дивляться на них. От розкажіть, що ви відчуваєте, коли ви дивитесь на них?
Я відчуваю дуже велику цікавість, і всі шукають чогось, що має українську, якийсь український дух в ньому, чи то сорочка, чи книжка, чи писанка, і навіть ті, що не українці, цікавляться, так що ми є дуже раді, що таке зацікавлення є.
Скажи мені, як тебе звати?
Максим.
Максим? Максим, давай, розкажи мені про своє враження про український фестиваль.
Воно тут дуже гарно, тут... Тут, якщо ви подивитеся, за нами є там, де ці лазять люди, діти на цих, як на горах. Я не знаю, і тут це ми зараз на Блурі. Тут український фестиваль кожного року.
І тобі подобається цей український фестиваль?
Дуже подобається.
І от як ти сюди кожного року їздиш?
Так, да, я насправді живу в Україні, в Києві. Ну, я тут буду жити, я тут десь не поблизько живу, ну тут дуже цікаво. Ну, я хочу, щоб зробили більше атракціонів наступного року.
During all this, there was non-stop entertainment on the main festival stage with performers from all over Canada, the US and Ukraine.
Ти щасливий будеш, ти щасливий будеш, ти щасливий будеш, грай, музико, грай, а мене забудеш, а мене забудеш, а мене забудеш, грай, музико, грай.
Every year the festival presents a main headliner act. This year it was the Kozak System from Kyiv. And every festival goer was presented with an opportunity to meet these artists at an autograph signing opportunity on Saturday afternoon at the premises of the headline sponsors, the Ukrainian Credit Union.
Сьогодні ми будемо грати свою програму, яка війшла в альбом «Шабля». І будемо грати, це як сюрприз для всіх слухачів, будемо грати декілька пісень із нашого спільного проєкту з Тарасом Чубаєм. І як супер-супер сюрприз, на сцену з нами вийде знаменитий український і вже тепер канадський скрипач Василь Попадюк.
This year, the festival main stage program was emceed by the Dobryansky brothers from New York City, who not only were able to introduce other performers to the stage, but were able to entertain the crowds with their own performances. This year, the festival's media sponsor and the Ukrainian-Canadian community's TV network of record, KONTAKT, set up an informal festival TV studio that became a meeting place for various celebrities that came to visit the festival. Here we have TV personality Petro Maha from KU, violin virtuoso Vasil Popodyuk, hosted by Toronto's 450 UA segment Andriy Holovaty, clowning around with photographer Yuri Bilak from Paris.
Добрий день, Юрко.
Добрий день, добрі люди. Добрий день, Канада. Добрий день, Торонто.
Скажи, яка...
Юрко, ти не запрошений в цю телевізійну програму.
То що мені робити? Вийти, зайти,
співати,
танцювати.
Принеси нам каву, будь ласка.
Каву, добре.
Тут є все нормально.
О, браво, браво. Прошу, дивіться.
Надійний хлоп, дуже дякую.
Дякую. А можна мені ще меду?
Добре. І Петро вже готовий, я бачу. А я все в авті лишив. Я можу ключі до авто дати. Ну, чекай. Я також. Прошу.
Дякую.
Гарно, дякую дуже. А, дивіться.
Голодач, як не хочеш каву, приходь.
Dr. Marko Stech, host of Ion Culture, chatted with rock personality Taras Chubayev, Ukraine.
Кого із України ти хотів би бачити на цій сцені на майбутніх фестивалях, українських фестивалях у Торонто? І я маю специфічно таке просто побажання, щоб ти, як людина, яка в самому середині, в самому ядрі цієї культури перебуває, сказала нам, українцям в Канаді, що зараз відбувається в українській музиці, що варто слухати, і специфічно, що в такому контексті вуличного фестивалю могло би спрацювати.
Я бачу це як таку трохи проблему, бо, скажімо, на початку 90-х, коли я починав, то все була така величезна хвиля такої свободи і свободи митецької, перш за все.
Абсолютно.
Не треба було догаджати якимось радіо чи телеформатом. І люди творили досить вільне мистецтво. Зараз з тим трошки складніше, і треба вже шукати цікавих цих виконавців, і це не завжди легко. Так. От, я знаю, що багато зараз молодих колективів з'являється, особливо у Львові. От, мені це дуже симпатично, це моє рідне місто.
Festival chair and executive producer of KONTAKT hosted ambassador of Ukraine Vadim Pristaiko and president of the Ukrainian Canadian Congress Pavlo Grod about international affairs and Canada's relationship with Ukraine.
Ми вважали, чесно вважали, що цього року ми вже підпишемо цю угоду. Більше того, президент на початку року в своїй програмі економічній сказав, що я український президент, що ми теж дбаємо, український уряд, про вільну торгівлю, про те, щоб покращити умови. І до кінця цього року ми підпишемо угоду з Канадою про вільну торгівлю. Він назвав, крім Канади, ще одну лише країну, тобто по всьому світу, і ми цього очікували. На жаль, зараз, як сталося останнім часом, ідея була ця призупинена, і прогресу ми ніякого не бачимо. Наші делегації мали зустрітися, цього теж не відбулося, і з цього ми виходимо, що прогресу немає, відсутній він.
Конгрес українців Канади, я скажу, що одна з перших тих, що готова сказати, що там діється і чому, як маємо покращити. Але дуже часто це транслюється в політиків, як, ага, українська громада в Канаді не задоволена ситуацією в Україні, тому що ми також дуже бити молотком і декларативно також говорити, що там є великі проблеми, і ми це вимагаємо. Що це стається? Відмежуються країни від одного другого. Ми це бачили. Ми бачимо, що, можливо, ми помилково поступали, що ми заохочували, щоб уряд так дуже агресивно ставився до України. Ми що боїмося? Ми не хочемо, щоб західний світ, Канада спеціально, ізолювалися від України. І ми бачимо, що досить тепер та ізоляція стається.
Saturday evening was the festival highlight for the youth of our community, as the festival headliner rock band Kozak System from Ukraine, sponsored by the Ukrainian Credit Union and Celebrate Ontario, took to the stage and brought excitement for all. Once again, after the main stage acts were finished, most young people headed to the festival after-party venue for continued entertainment and dancing. Sunday started off with a community ecumenical prayer organized and presented by representatives of local churches in the Bloor West Village area. This ecumenical service has fostered a building community spirit that today carries beyond the festival itself.
A year ago, we were sitting around the table after our meeting, and a number of the pastors grabbed a second cup of coffee, and someone said, "I'm really going to miss these meetings. I'm loving getting to know each other." And someone else said, "Well, why? Why do we need to stop?" And so we have been able to reform the Bloor West Village Ministerial. And once a month, the pastors of the Bloor West Village get together for breakfast at the Grenadier and have a good time of sharing together, coordinating together, and then praying together. So it's a wonderful opportunity that is developed out of that as well. So that's another little side story to this whole service.
A special two-hour youth program was reserved for young and budding future artists of the festival youth stage and started right at noon.
Що шукає у сині края.
A regular visitor of the festival each year is Minister of Economic Development and Multiculturalism, Jason Kenny, who was immediately proclaimed an honorary Ukrainian on the main festival stage and received an embroidered Ukrainian shirt from UCC President Paul Grod.
This is the community that conceived of the idea. Senator Paul Juzik, a proud son of Ukrainian immigrants, who said, "We need a way to recognize the Canadians who are neither of British nor French nor First Nations origin, recognize their contributions, their pride in their cultures." This is the community that started it and continues to give such a beautiful and vital expression to our multiculturalism.
Minister Kenny had just returned from Banff from the official opening of the Cave and Basin Internment Exhibit, which was designed to educate Canadian and international visitors about Canada's First World War internment operations from 1914 to 1920.
In that beautiful place, there was a great sadness, and that the people who maybe felt a certain shame because of their internment and didn't talk about it, there was no reason for them to feel shame. They were proud, honest, hardworking Canadians. The Ukrainian Canadians contributed thousands to the Canadian forces in the First War, including Victoria Cross winners. And this whole thing was so wrong, so unjust. And I also thank the community for recalling it, bringing this back from a forgotten memory to a lesson for the future. And so, that was really the theme of what I said. And we had a really wonderful turnout and a lot of sons and daughters of internees and others who had been registered during the First World War operations.
Minister Kenny also gave us the newest details of the Victims of Communism Monument being proposed for Ottawa.
The site is a magnificent site, right next to the Supreme Court, steps from Parliament Hill, which will be our national Canadian monument to the victims of communism. Something like 100 million people
whose lives were taken directly or indirectly by brutal communist regimes, including the millions of Ukrainians who died in not just the Holodomor of 32-33, but other famines and Soviet communist violence. So this will be a place of collective memory for all of those affected communities, be they Vietnamese, Korean, Ukrainian, Polish, all of the different communities. It will also be a place of permanent memory, sacred memory of the lives that were taken and of education. I don't want to see young Canadians walking down the street wearing a hammer and sickle on their t-shirt or a Lenin, picture of Lenin on their t-shirt or a red star on their cap or CCCP or USSR. These symbols should be as stigmatized as Nazi and fascist symbols are. And this is a collective project working with the communities, private donors and government to make that happen, to say this was one of the most brutal ideologies in human history, and the memory of it should be considered in shame for the evil that it was.
На сам кінець до фестивалю прибув мер міста Торонто і заговорив до всіх на сцені.
I can't believe there's 600,000 people that came here. It gets bigger and bigger and better and better every year. So thank you so much for coming out. And if I can ever help anybody out, you know that. You come down to my office. I'm there to help you. I return every phone call. And I want to congratulate the organizers of this fantastic Ukrainian festival. God bless everyone. The last thing you want to hear is a politician go on and go on. But I want to thank everyone for their support. And there's a big election next year. And let's go get them. All the best to you. Thank you so much.
Just before the end of the festival, Mayor of Toronto Rob Ford dropped by for a visit and was presented with an engraving of Taras Shevchenko by Parisian artist Yervan Bouvet.
So I'm standing here, like you're the real Rob Ford.
I'm the real Rob Ford. Oh. I love the Ukrainian community. It's amazing. They're hardworking people. They create jobs in our community. What more can you ask for?
They love you too.
I love them more.
I wish I could vote for you.
No, that's all right. Don't worry. We'll see what happens.
Tell my friends to vote for you.
We'll see what happens next October 27th. I keep taxes low and I create jobs for everybody. Well, but the Ukrainian people are the ones who go out and start the jobs. They're the ones who are out there creating jobs, sacrificing their own money, and it's paying off.
Makes great.
Absolutely. I want to thank the Ukrainian community for putting this festival on, and it's absolutely fantastic.
You know what, Your Worship? You make the city great, too. So don't let anyone
We're trying. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it, sir. Thank you. God bless you, too. Thanks, everyone. Take care.
The mayor was greeted by all as a rock star. At that point, MC Yulia Drozdowska called upon the Barvinok Dance Ensemble to close the 17th annual Bloor West Village Ukrainian Festival with their traditional and spectacular double-tier Ukrainian hopak.
Хай ваші серця наповняться гордістю за нашу славну матір Україну!